Hi, I'm Justin from WagonTech, and today we're going to take a look at some of the most common questions asked about power inverters, like what are the uses, what type of inverter do I need, what are the differences between inverters, and which one is right for me. So let's dive right into it. First, let's take a look at what a power inverter is. It takes DC current, which is the battery power from your car, and turns it into AC current, which is like what you find in the wall outlet of your house. Power inverters come in two main categories. Your standard plug and play models, which you simply plug into the 12 volt DC accessory outlet of your car, and the hardwired model. These ones require you to run a positive and a negative power cable to your vehicle's battery. So you may ask, what kind of appliances can you use with a power inverter? They can be used with anything that runs off of AC power, from a blender to a curling iron, to a cooktop, to a crane even. They can be used for a myriad of things. We have police departments, fire departments, ambulance crews, and even civil services that use our power inverters daily across the world. So you may be asking yourself, well, that's great. All these other people use power inverters, but what would I use a power inverter for? You could use it for your laptop, powering a DVD player. You know, when you're out tailgating, you want to run that blender. You can certainly do it with a power inverter. Even when you're camping, you can have a straight iron, you can have a hairdryer, or anything else you need. Even CPAP machines for people that require those. Now let's take a look at the different types of sine waves. You have modified and pure sine wave. Modified, also known as square sine waves, are manufactured sine waves that work with most devices. Pure sine wave, or natural sine, is the same sine wave that comes out of the outlet in your house and works with every device. Pure sine wave is ideal because the voltage rises and falls smoothly and changes polarity instantly when the voltage crosses 0 volts. This does not cause excessive heat buildup or add stress to electronic devices, as it is smooth and a consistent change. On the other hand, modified sine wave is more like a light switch, with abrupt voltage rises and falls with long periods of rest at 0 volts. This abrupt change causes some devices to simply not operate. It can also create electrical noise in some devices as well. Okay, so which sine wave is right for you? Are you gonna be running medical devices, like a CPAP machine, or are you just gonna be running a blender? If you're running a medical device or sensitive electronics, like printers, fax machines, computers, you'll want pure sine. Pretty much anything else that isn't a clock or doesn't have an oscillation or isn't a fluorescent light, you can use with modified sine wave. Okay, so now you have a basic understanding of what a modified and pure sine wave is. Now you're probably asking yourself, so what inverter do I need? You need to take a look at the wattage requirements of your appliance in order to answer that question. Most devices will have the wattage or amperage requirements posted on the device itself. It may say 75 watts or 5 amps. If your device doesn't list the wattage, here's how you can calculate it. Take the volts times the amps, and that equals watts. For instance, let's take a look at this lamp. On the bottom, the label says 120 volts at 0.5 amps. So you take the 120 times the 0.5 and you get 60 watts. Another thing you don't want to neglect is the amount of appliances you're gonna run at one time. Just because your lamp requires 60 watts doesn't mean you shouldn't include the other devices in the calculation. So if you're running two devices at the same time, make sure you calculate both of those devices' wattages up in order to make sure you get the correct power inverter. For example, you have a laptop that's 60 watts, and let's say you have a portable DVD player that's 40 watts. You'll add those two wattages up, 60 and 40, and you'll come up with 100 watts. So now you've calculated the 100 watts. That sounds good, but it may not be the ideal inverter for your needs. You'll be taxing the inverter if you get a 100 watt inverter and put a 100 watt load on it. So that's why we suggest a 20% buffer. So what you would do is take your 100 watts, add 20% to it, and come up with 120 watts. That would be a better fitting inverter for your needs. Lastly, let's talk about peak surge. You may have heard of it before and been wondering what it means. What it is when a high wattage device starts up, it draws an insane amount of power for usually less than 1/2 of a second. That's called the peak surge of the device. Some devices can surge up to 3 times the amount of its running wattage. This is something you need to take a look at when selecting an appropriate inverter for your needs. All right, so that's the end of our basic overview of power inverters. Make sure you like this video, subscribe to our channel, turn on those notifications, because we have lots more videos going in depth about inverters and how to connect them coming up soon. Thank you very much for watching this video. Oh yeah, for more information about inverters, go to www.wagon.com. That's W-A-G-A-N.com. Hi, I'm Justin.
Ooh.